Hey, you're listening to Coffee Talk with Liquidshano 1973. Here's your host, Shane Likita.
Hey everybody, it's another episode of Coffee Talk with Liquidshano 1973. Welcome back. I'm here because it's a new year. I'm here because all of you are here with me, and we are grinding out this thing we call life together, one step at a time, one way at a time, and one journey at a time, and one obstacle at a time. As each one of us are trying to be able to keep moving forward, I'm so happy and appreciative that you're here with me as we are going through it together. Now, I know that you guys are all the way up with me up to episode number 135, which blows me away right now that we're at episode 135 on this podcast. But I've gotten a lot of really great feedback, especially on the last episode on 134, where there was a lot of folks just listening in and being able to hear the story and the inspirational journey of J.K. Rowling, and then also talking about overcoming adversity and hearing a few no's that stops us from being able to keep moving forward. And this episode that we're going to talk about here today is very similar. It's very similar to the concept that we are labeled as going a certain direction in our lives and labeled as doing something that maybe at one point or time or another that we've been told that we can't do something, or we've kind of understood or accepted the fact that it's hereditary or passed down to us that we're not going to be able to move forward in certain spaces. Maybe none of our family was athletic. Maybe none of our family was collegiate or smart with the books or street smart. And so we've never been taught that way, and none of our family members were ever that way as we've ever lived in the past. So we think that we're that way also. But the time to change that is now, because we define our own destiny. I put a post out a couple days ago on a Coffee Talk blog that I was writing, and on the post it said basically that the only person that can hold you back from achieving the things that you want to achieve is you. And why do you not accomplish the things that you want to accomplish? You know, we have all these dreams and aspirations and things that we're trying to do and where we're trying to go in life and where we're trying to be able to accomplish all these things left and right, all over the place, right? And all the times we set down goals, we put down dream boards, we think about to ourselves, what is it that I want to go and accomplish, and what do I want to do with my life? And here we are, it's January 3rd today, and we are all in the mode now, think about it, after the new year. Everybody's brushing off the treadmills, everybody's scraping off the gym memberships, going out there and getting the new gym memberships, going out to get that whole new feeling of reignition of the journey that you're trying to be on, or the feeling of wanting to be able to push forward and be a better version of yourself and keep moving on and keep moving forward, right? I mean, all of us are right there. It's the new year. This is what we do. A lot of people will set things like New Year's resolutions or New Year's promises or goals or aspirations and those kind of things. And we all feel really great about things. And then all of a sudden at around maybe February or March timeframe, those huge high energy things, some do stay the course and bravo to those that do. And some are about mediocre. Maybe they're delivering on some of the things that they were delivering so highly and so energetically with the way that they were in the month of January. And some fall right off the cliff and they give up on those goals because they feel like they can't do it, or they feel like it's too hard for the work, or they feel like life has gotten in the way, or whatever it is, right? I mean, we've all been there, all of us. Every single one of us have been down the road of doubting ourselves, of putting ourselves down, of making ourselves feel like, oh, you know, hey, here I am trying to be able to do it, but I can't do it because of such and such a reason. And we make all these excuses across the board, all of them, these thousands of excuses. And the excuses outweigh the actual reasons that you can do it so often. Because we can make 1,000,000,000,000,000,000 excuses towards not accomplishing something. But when you look at somebody and say, what makes you think that you can? You could pretty much hear crickets every single time that somebody sits back and says, well, I think I can because I've got the motivation and the drive. That's a really tough one. But if you ask, why do you think you can't do it? Well, you know, my bones hurt, my knees hurt, my legs hurt, my arms hurt. You know, it's hereditary. It's in my family. I'm not made that way. I'm not made to run. I'm not made to swim. My body's not wired that way. I've got all these things going on. I got high blood pressure. I got all this stuff. every excuse in the book that we have, we can list from top to bottom of why we don't accomplish the things that we're trying to accomplish, or things that we want to be, or version of ourselves that we want to become. We do it all the time. I do it all the time. And this is really just a reflection of me. Because for me, when somebody says to me, well, how come you haven't accomplished that certain thing that you've always set your mind to, and you've always had on your mind to be able to accomplish, I will always have a reason why I can't do it, or I did not do it yet. But at the end of the day, when I'm really thinking about it, there's no reason why I shouldn't be able to accomplish it. There's no reason why I shouldn't be able to put one foot in front of the other and accomplish all of my dreams and aspirations and goals and dreams, all of them. Why can't we? What's the reason? Is it easier to make excuses and not accomplish things? Is that what it is? I mean, it is kind of easy when you think about it. Making reasons of why we can't do something is much easier than trying to dig hard to overcome obstacles to get to the place where we want to go. I mean, really, it's the easiest path of resistance. If I don't accomplish something, oh, great, I'll just make an excuse for the reason why I didn't do that. Well, the only reason that that excuse can be valid is if it's a medical reason or if there's something really, really big that did happen. Listen, I know life happens and there will be reasons why things get in the way. But the only thing that holds you back from not eventually accomplishing your goals and your dreams and your aspirations is you. And the other thing about it is as you're reflecting on this, as I'm reflecting on it, I also have to forgive myself for the fact that, you know, I may make those excuses, but I've made those in the past because that is what human nature does. We make excuses for things that we don't accomplish because we sit back and we say to ourselves, how in the world did I not accomplish that? And now I feel guilty about not accomplishing it, or I feel bad or down in the dumps, or I feel like I'm a failure, or I feel like, you know, I'm really ashamed of everything that I did here. So I need to make an excuse because the excuse will make up the reason why I'm so ashamed. And then I'll be able to at least feel a little bit better about myself for not accomplishing the things that I wanted to accomplish. Forgive yourself. Hey, listen, you know what? I didn't get it done. Okay, so you know what? Now I need to set a new set of goals. I need to start my path going down the road of where I wanted to go. Maybe break it down into smaller size chunks, littler things that I can actually accomplish and be able to dive into and be able to focus on and be able to accomplish. So that way I know that my big prize at the end of my journey or the end of my goal or my whatever I'm trying to be able to accomplish is accomplished, is something that I can do because I'm breaking it down into smaller sizes. And it's not just one huge monumentous gigantosaurus of a mountain that I have to accomplish. I'm going to tell you guys a story. I know last time I talked about J.K. Rowling, who is an author that was told by 12 publishers. I think I went over all the details on that with you guys. If you haven't listened to it, poke over to episode 134 and jam out on that one and be able to hear her story behind that because she overcame obstacles of no's and people being negative. But I want you to hear this story about an individual that I'm inspired by, okay? And like I said, the next 10 to 15 episodes, I'm going to go through people that inspire me, that drive me to focus on really not making excuses for things that I'm going through, not letting life step in the way, or not letting people tell me no, or not letting the journey itself hold me back, or any of those things. Now, this person that I'm talking about right now, her name is Liz Murray. And let me go ahead and tell you the story. I got it written down over here, so I'm going to read it to you real quick. So Liz, when she was 15 years old, became homeless, okay? Just after her mother died of HIV and her father moved to a homeless shelter when she was that age. She was in such an extremely painful situation, most people would only be able to see their immediate circumstances. Now I want you to think about this. Think about yourself if you're at 15 years old, your mother dies of the dreaded HIV virus and father moved into a homeless shelter. And now you're by yourself. You're homeless. You don't have a roof over your head. You're poor. You have no money. You have nothing. And all obstacles are against you. How would you respond? Just in a really quick snapshot, 15 years old, how would you respond? Would you be sad, devastated? Would you go down the road of, like many people do when they're at that age and they're homeless, drugs and alcohol and the streets and prostitution and those kind of things, or whatever it is, to be able to try to make ends meet because you don't have any money or income or anything like that coming in, right? Most people would only be able to see their immediate circumstances. But Liz would seek a better reality for herself, despite her intense limitations. So what she did is she got up on her feet and she attended a local high school and graduated that high school in just 2 years. Okay. Normal 4-year program. She graduated in just 2 years. She studied. She worked hard. She said, I'm not going to be told no. I'm going to this high school. I'm homeless. I was, you know, I was in the bottom of the barrel, and I'm going to focus on making sure that I'm better and do all the things that I have to do. She was then awarded a New York Times scholarship for needy students and was accepted into Harvard University, eventually earning her doctorate in clinical psychology. She's since written a New York Times best-selling memoir, Breaking Night, A Memoir of Forgiveness, Survival, and My Journey from Homeless to Harvard. If you haven't had a chance, check it out. It's an inspiring, inspiring book. And it's also been made for a TV movie. Liz is inspiring to me because she didn't let her circumstances dictate her future. She chose her own destiny, she manifested it, and despite everything that she was going through, all the obstacles that were thrown her way, everything that was thrown at her, being homeless at 15, losing her mother of HIV, her dad being homeless as well, all those things, all across the board, 9 times out of 10 probably would have broken somebody down. And they would have fallen off to the wayside, they would have given up, and they would have made excuses to be in the fact of, well, I didn't ask for that. I didn't ask when I was 15 years old to be homeless. I didn't ask to be out of school. I didn't ask to do all these things. Instead, she persevered and she overcame. And she stepped up and she said, you know what? This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to fight for me. I'm going to continue to grind it out and keep pushing forward and do the things that are necessary for me to do to be successful, to be somebody that is inspirational, to be somebody that can move forward and move mountains whenever she wanted to. Think about that just for a second. Then I want you to think about yourself. And I want you to think to yourself, whatever situation that you're in, whether how bleak it is or whether how minuscule it is, it's still big to you. So whatever the situation may be, and it's facing you and life is facing you and you're looking at it and you're going, man, this is really difficult and this is something that I have to go through. Doesn't minimize your journey or your obstacles you have to overcome compared to what she had to go through, but I want you to compare the two. Because the real root, at the back end of this is that no matter what you're going through, and no matter how heavy it is, and no matter how light it is, and no matter what direction that life is going to take you or wants to take you or throw at you or bash you in the face or any of those things, no matter what happens, no matter where it goes and what's going on with it, nothing is too big for you to overcome. Nothing. Even people that have been diagnosed with terminal cancer or other illnesses or anything like that. Even folks that have a bleak circumstance still fight every day to either battle against whatever it is that they're fighting or live the fullest life that they've ever lived. And they choose to put one foot in front of the other and never let it stop them. I want you to think about that because I think about that all the time. When I was seeing this and I was seeing her story, I thought to myself, man, my little circumstances that I have going on here, like I said, although are big to me and my family, but my little circumstances are nothing compared to being homeless, losing your mother to HIV, having a dad that's homeless as well, and you deciding to follow the path, whatever path of the direction you want to go in that T in the road, she went down the path of success. And she focused and she worked and she grinded and she did not stop. She was not going to be told no, and she was going to be great. We need to make sure that we focus on making sure that we can go down that path of greatness. Because no matter what your version of greatness might look like, you may not be a Harvard valedictorian or magna cum laude or whatever else that they have at the top collegiate levels. You may not be anything like that, but you may be successful in whatever you're trying to be able to accomplish. So if you can accomplish some of the things that you're trying to fight for, that means something to you. That gives your version of greatness for you. And if you accomplish these things, that means you have fought to get there. If these are dreams and aspirations, these aren't things you can just check off your checklist like brushing your teeth or making your bed. These are things like, I want to accomplish goals, my professional goals, my personal goals, my fitness goals, my health goals, all those things. And these are the ways that I'm going to do it, and I'm going to fight like hell to get them without anybody telling me that I can't do it. Especially without you telling yourself you can't do it. I want you to think what she had to go through to overcome the adversity in her brain, the adversity morally, the adversity in her own compass that she was trying to be able to navigate, and how many obstacles was thrown at her and hit her in the face. And she just decided, I'm going to keep fighting for me. I'm not going to make excuses. And I open this whole podcast with the fact of we make excuses so easily for all the things that we can't accomplish or we don't accomplish or that we fail at. We make excuses all the time, almost like they're like handing out candy because they're so readily available. Everything has an excuse layered in there. But she didn't think about excuses. She thought of, how do I overcome it? Not, why is this happening to me? She thought, I'm going to be the best version of me. Not, well, life dictates this is the direction I need to move in, so I'm worth nothing. She could have easily gone down that road, but she didn't. And you don't either. You shouldn't either. All of us are worth so much more than what we give ourselves credit for. And if you can really focus in on that, I know if I can focus in on that and really show what I'm really worth, I think that me personally, if I just invest in that and I show exactly how much I want to fight for me and how much I want to stop making excuses for not accomplishing the things that I want to accomplish in life, whether it's professionally, whether it's through our YouTube cast, whether it's through this podcast, whether it's through anything, stop doubting myself and keep fighting and pushing forward and grinding and one foot in front of the other and not ever stopping. Because you deserve to do that for yourself. You deserve to invest in you. You deserve to achieve great things, no matter what anybody's ever told you before, and no matter what society tries to tell you that you can't accomplish. You can do whatever it takes and whatever you need to do to be able to accomplish great things. The only person that stands in the way of you and that outcome is you, nobody else. It's your headspace. It's where you're at. Are you going to tell yourself no, or are you going to tell yourself, I can do whatever I need to do? Are you going to set goals that you're going to be able to go accomplish and say, I'm going to fight through that and not let these personal obstacles get in my way? Or are you going to say, yeah, you know what? I'm not really feeling it. So I'm going to back off right now. And then maybe I'll be just, maybe I'll get back to it later or whatever. And then you'll forget about it or whatever. Which route are you going to choose? Who are you going to be able to try to accomplish? Or what are you going to do to be able to accomplish the things that you need to accomplish, right? That's what I have to ask myself. How bad do I want it? Because if I want it bad enough, I should be able to accomplish whatever, whenever, and however I want to. And so should you. All of us. Every one of us are worth that much. And we should be able to accomplish all of our dreams, all of our aspirations. Let's go out. New Year's here. Let's go make it happen. And let's not let life dictate what our outcome is going to be. Okay? We'll talk later.
Thanks for listening to the Coffee Talk with Liquidshano 1973 podcast. You can also follow him on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Liquidshano 1973. Also, if you get a chance, leave some love on iTunes. Have a great day.